Daniel Findley. I'm a senior research associate at the Institute for Transportation Research and Education. We work here on the Centennial Campus at NC State University. We look at anything that moves, any mode of transportation. We look at anything from the roadways to pedestrian facilities to airports and ferries. It's one of the major importances of looking at a roadway is who are the users, when do they need to use it, and how will they use it. This is Avent Ferry Road. This is near the campus of NC State. Primarily, there's a lot of commuter and student traffic. So you'll see a pickup of traffic when the class breaks are. You'll see in the morning at 8 o'clock, a lot of professionals, and at 9 o'clock also professionals and professors that are coming to campus. And then you'll also see a lot of buses on this route. Math plays a huge role from the operations and the design and other characteristics as well, such as safety. From the design perspective, there's two major components we think about when we're thinking about the design. Both the left to right movement, so the horizontal alignment of the roadway. So if we look kind of down the roadway here, we'll see the road does curve over to the left, kind of in the distance there. And then also vertically at the same point, you'll see that there's a grade that slopes downhill from where we are now. And then in the distance, you can see it sloping uphill. So to make that transition, there's a curve or a vertical curve. And the way we explain a vertical curve is through the parabolic equation, which is y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. And that helps us determine where the road will physically be located. If we don't design curves, it's basically two straight sections of roadway. And vertically, what that looks like is that looks like a ramp. So if we don't design the curve, you're building a ramp, which might be fun for race car drivers or stunt drivers, but for the general public, that's not a good idea. So we need to connect those two straight sections of roadway with a curve to make that transition. So that's really what the idea behind a parabolic curve for vertical alignment is to provide that smooth transition so that vehicles maintain their equilibrium and can travel at the speed they would like to travel along that roadway. The reason why I enjoy what I do is because I think it makes a difference. I think it helps with our transportation system. Everyone's always going somewhere, whether, you know, the range of transportation modes from flying to driving to walking to bicycling. Helping them go places more safely and more efficiently is important, and anything we can do to help that or provide that safe and efficient access is a positive. Also enjoy working with math and incorporating math into my job, because that's how good and fact-based decisions can be made. If we're not using math and we're not using data, we're just guessing and we're just using judgment. And the result of that usually is not going to result in the optimum decision. So that's why I really like using math, and I enjoy using math, and it's a part of our everyday job is to incorporate math and data into our decision making.